Welcome to the latest episode of Blade Shade. I don't mean to get anyone's hopes up, but I think Bitter Cold Showdown might be planning a comeback. Don't call it a comeback. Mind your own business, LL Cool J. Alright, no need for violence. A bunch of you may have noticed that Bitter Cold Showdown have started updating quite frequently onto their Instagram account, and if you look on their page, they've also got a website listed. If you go to the website, there isn't actually anything there at the moment, but the fact that the domain exists in the first place is promising. Plus, on one of their recent posts, it's just a looped video that says one more time. So, could it mean that we're getting one more event? One more time! The US doesn't really have that many major competitions at the moment. You've got the Boshy Pope Skate Off in New York City, and you've got Bladen Cup in Santa Ana, but the last couple of Bladen Cups, the obstacles have been quite small, so it would be nice to see a major event where people are really pushing the boundaries of the sport again. So yeah, keep your eyes peeled for that. Speaking of comebacks, don't call it a comeback! Right, you're really starting to get on my tits, LL. Dominic Sigona is back in the streets. Now, I don't know if he's planning a full comeback. I don't know if we're going to get any sections from him. But just seeing one of my favourite skaters of all time out doing topsoils and back royales on ledges brings me nothing but joy. Plus, if you look in some of his recent Instagram posts, he has hinted that he's working on a promo. I think it might be a recreational one for the Power Slide next. But yeah. Any clips are good clips when it's Dom Sigona. Anyone else notice that Richie Eisler has also been very active recently on Instagram? Now, I wouldn't exactly call it a comeback because he didn't go anywhere. Well, he did fuck off to China for several years. But let's be honest, the past few years, he's really been phoning it in terms of producing content for his sponsors. In fact, his last few wheel promos were like basically one day edits in parks or solely filmed on 360 cams. So hopefully we're going to see a comeback from him. Maybe he's trying to get a new pro skate, get some of those increased royalties. I see what you're up to, Mr. Eisler. The past month has been incredible for videos. We kick things off with Them Skates and Dear Audrey. The latest video from Them Skates features short mini sections from most of the riders. Alex Brosco eases into proceedings with his trademark style, and a passerby vocalized what many of us have been saying about Alex for the past two decades.
He makes it look easy, shit.
He does.
You know?
He really does.
Even someone with the talent Leon Humphreys possesses can't quite figure out how Alex Brosco is so good.
It's a bit unfair sometimes.
If you want to know when Alex Brosco is going to slow down and become predictable, the answer is not anytime soon. If you require proof, just look at this 360 over the skip to Hillbomb in San Francisco. The clip in the video doesn't actually do it justice, but if you've seen the side angle on Instagram, he goes fast and that thing is long. The only negative thing I have to say about this video is when JK Park did a fakie hill bomb and almost gave me a fucking heart attack. He's cruising down fakie, casual as you like, just pops in a zero spin for the hell of it, and then a 4x4 appears out of nowhere, and you think for a split second he's gonna become roadkill. Most other skaters would have panicked, crashed into the thing, or given themselves third degree road rash by just spiraling out. JK just casually swerves around it and keeps on going. Then we also get to see some technical wizardry from him. Yes, that is a fakie bonk to topsoil, true spin soul, out. We may have been waiting on the Marius Gale skate promo since last year, but it's tough to be mad at him when he's giving us clips like this. The double wall rides, inspired. The bonk to fish brain wasn't bad either. Sean Darst may be responsible for the most boring skate promo of all time. It was about 5 minutes long and had about 10 tricks, and half of them were either topsoils or royales. But his ender section in Dear Audrey is absolutely incredible. I think he's got like 3 minutes worth of footage, and it's just hill bombs, technical tricks, clever switch ups. There's also a kink rail to hill bomb thrown in for good measure. One else knows. You and my heart. Yeah. The guy just makes really good use of the San Francisco terrain, shows us how good he is, and this ender is an absolute joke.
You better believe it.
I don't know many people who would be up for trying that. I think most people would look at that and go, that's not a spot. Less than a week after Dear Audrey dropped, Austin Paz brought out his long-awaited new section, By the Slice, which was excellently filmed and edited by Butter TV. He talks to some random bald Scottish guy about it in a podcast. You might be able to see the link to it below. Like any good Austin Paz section, it features his textbook True Spin topsoil, which I'm going to argue is one of the best in blading.
36 chambers, 25 years from now. The way I see the new kids coming in, they come out, woo, tang.
He also does a switch up on the famous Stuyvesant rail, which according to iRollNY is an NBD. They think that no one else has done that. I mean, iRollNY will know better than anyone. They are the locals. Shout out iRollNY. We also get to see a really creative side to Austin Paz. He shows off some wizard skating, he shows off some mushroom blading, and as this guy says,
it's butter, baby! Shit!
He also brings back the old school with a topside training wheel. Then there's this ridiculous fakey 540 topsoil that I didn't think I'd seen anyone do in street before. Turns out I had seen someone do it in street before, and that someone is Mark Wojda. Mark Wojda? How do you pronounce that guy's name? Although he did also do that fakie 540 solo down that scary ledge in the same section, so Mark Wojda has proven himself to be a bit of a nut job. Either way, Austin's trick, still amazing. The only issue I had with the whole video was this one clip. I don't even have a problem with the trick. The trick is perfectly executed. That is one of the best AWOLs I have seen on a rail ever. The problem I have is with the idiots online who can't name the trick properly. One person said, I used to call that a tip truck soyal. Well, you used to call it the wrong thing. Another person said, I used to think that was called a nine bar, but I'm probably wrong. You are wrong, it's called an AWOL. Alfie Smith commented, wouldn't this be a rough soyal? No, it wouldn't. Jonathan Toribio said, this isn't a real trick, LMAOWTF. Well, first off, it is a real trick, and I have no respect for people who use acronyms, especially WTF. People who use WTF are probably the kind of guy that texts a girl and says DTF. How about get to fuck? And Leroy Jenkins said, that's basically a backslide, the sole foot is hovering. It's not hovering, and it's not a backslide. You are right about one thing though. It is incredible. And rounding out an excellent week for content, possibly the best week for content in 2022 so far, Mesmer Skates released RV There Yet. I love the fact that Mesmer are continuing with the pun theme. First they had Mesmerizing, now we've got RV There Yet. Are we there yet? See what they did there? It may not be the face melter that the first team edit was, but I just love the fact that they're getting the whole team together and it seems like a unified group. It seems like a unit. There's not many other teams in blading that seem like that. The only other ones I can really think of are Demskates and Rosies. So it's just brilliant that they've got that kind of camaraderie going on. It's not just, you know, a randomly selected group of individuals who don't really have anything to do with each other. One of the standouts in this video was Gabriel Adriani. He's on the AM team and he puts in a solid performance. He clearly went to America and went, right, I'm getting to work. He had a bunch of clips in the video and I was impressed with them. Old man Billy O'Neill also held it down. He had some good footage in there, including this in-spin front salve. Don't kill me for saying salve instead of alley-oop unity. It also showcased a rare instance of John Bellino getting shown up at a spot. So they're at this ditch and John Bellino busts out a perfect cork 720, which we've seen before, still impressive. Then Dominic Bruce follows up with a 900, clean as you like, then comes from a fakie to forward heel roll, fakie out. It's kind of like he won up John and then went. Could this be the start of some rivalry between John Bellino and Dominic Bruce? Also, I just want to take this opportunity to make one thing clear. Mesmer is not a rocker company.
As we exist and we put out stuff, we can really make the distinction of ourselves not really being a rocker company.
Sure, they wear Misfits t-shirts, Electric Wizard t-shirts, and the Munson Band t-shirts, but they're not a rocker company. Sure, they sit about and play guitar and smoke weed, but they're not a rocker company. Sure, the majority of the music in their videos is rock music, but they're not a rocker company.
We can really make the distinction of ourselves not really being a rocker company.
Thanks for clearing that up, Billy. I've got your back. We also got some brilliant short videos this month. Chad Hornish brought out Farewell Pink. It's the last in the Pink series, and I'm pretty sure it's the last street footage he filmed in Arizona before moving to Texas. I have no idea how the hell they got away with using this ABBA track, but I am all for it. It works perfectly well with the skating. We also got to see a technical side to Chad Hornish, got to see this step up to toe roll to grind combination, which was flawless. This Macchio was also beautiful and high as hell. And this sketchy ledge with a shitty run up that he skates does not look appealing at all, but he laces the crap out of it. He also stomps this monster ditch gap at the end. He's getting towed in by a truck. You can see he is absolutely flying and the gap is pretty sizable, but when he rolls into the dirt, he just stops dead. He doesn't eat shit. He doesn't snap his tiny little twig legs in two. He just stops dead. What kind of witchcraft is that? Even Chad Hornish can't believe he got away with that.
Fuck yeah, dude. I snapped in the dirt.
Fuck yeah.
Yeah, you like
extended my legs, dude.
That's what I was gonna say. It was like an ankle breaker.
The only complaint I have about this video is it claims to be 3 minutes, but when you actually watch it, it's only 2 minutes long with about a minute of filler at the end. But I strongly recommend you check it out. Chad has been impressing me for years now, and it doesn't look like he's slowing down anytime soon. I just want to give a quick shout out to my Patreon supporters. They are listed on the page now. If you would like to support this channel, you can do so for as little as £3 a month, and it is greatly appreciated, mainly because I've got hardly any Patreon supporters. Unfortunately, not all video releases can be good video releases. Some end up being utter donkeys.
Donkey!
Like this one from Hedonskate, or more specifically, Adam Zurawitzki.
Adam Zurawitzki!
The section itself isn't actually that bad. The skating's pretty good. In fact, he's probably a better skater than me, so I can't really talk shit on him. But when you start including clips in your section that aren't really landed or don't really count, that's when I have to draw the line. And in this video, he has not one, not two, but three sloppy ass unlanded tricks that just don't count. First up is this Royale around the curve. He only gets halfway around the rail, which is a pretty short rail, and he almost instantly goes from Royale to frontside. Next up is a topside torso to true spin topso, which is all over the shop. It is not even remotely locked on. Followed instantly by a top acid to true top acid, again, not locked on at all. Like, this is one of these points where the filmer has to be like, look man, you've got to do that again. Or there has to be some kind of back and forth because, yeah, that shit just doesn't fly. And breathe. Sam Croft's latest Pro Skate from USD just dropped and is available in shops worldwide. That makes three Pro USD Aeons by my count. That means a promo is also on the way. Expect more brushes with death and entertaining altercations with security guards. Bonus. Sticking with Power Slide, they've also brought out a Power Slide Next Skate, and 100% of the profits are going to help charities that are involved with the Ukraine effort, which is absolutely excellent. The colorway is a little bit wild for my tastes, and if you've got wide feet like me, Next Skates are essentially torture devices, but if you've got narrow feet, they are worth giving a shot. Plus, it's all going to a good cause. Great. Not all new product releases are welcome product releases though, such as this new electric frame from Eastend. Apparently it goes up to speeds of 25k an hour, but it only lasts roughly 15k before needing charged. So after less than 10 miles, you're essentially screwed. Great for lazy bastards who love skating but don't actually want to skate. For everyone else, not so much. It literally removes one of the best selling points for skating, I think, which is the fact that it gives your legs an incredible workout and reaches muscles that most other exercises don't. And the two-wheel free skate setup with like those giant, like just wide, I can't even finish the sentence. It just upsets me too much. Please, see if you're going to get this. Just get an electric scooter. You know, it probably goes faster and the charge holds longer. Just don't do it. A couple of skaters have had amazing makeovers this year and I am all for it. Everyone's favorite stoner, Joey Lunger, has undergone several transformations over the years. We've seen, I used to be a fisherman in Alaska, Joey Lunger. We have also seen, I've tried ayahuasca in the desert, Joey Lunger. And we've also seen, do you know where I can buy some weed, Joey Lunger? But have you ever seen sexy Joey Lunger? I'm bringing sexy back. It kind of reminds me of like those teen coming of age movies where like the girl just has a minor makeover that involves just taking her specs off and shoving on some makeup and she comes down the stairs and the guy's like, whoa. Joey got bumped up to undercover pro this year and apparently he's got a pro wheel out very soon. If this is what happens when Joey Lunger gets put onto pro for undercover, imagine what we're going to get if he gets put onto pro for USD. I'm telling you, he's going to come out looking like a young Tom Cruise, all suave, six-pack, just ready to fuck up everything. Joey, I'm here for it. Speaking of transformations, everyone's favorite inverter and all-round nice guy, Miguel Camina, has also undergone a transformation and it is looking good. Miguel used to look like an extra from the Cheech and Chong films. Now he's got a shaved head and looking like something out of Prison Break. That is a really fucking old reference. I'm gonna need to think of something better than that. Either way, he's got a shaved head, he's looking aerodynamic and he's still killing it in the streets. To the top. With all these beautiful transformations going on in Bladen, I'm feeling like I need to follow suit. As soon as I make that YouTube money, hair transplant. I'm getting really fucking sick of everyone calling me Moby all the time.
Now, it's not something I think about.
Next up, I really feel that we need to give some respect to the veterans in Bladen. The over 40s have been absolutely killing it recently. First up, John Julio, who has just been finessing skate parks all over the place on Instagram. Here you can see him doing alley-oop topso to switch topso, then an alley-oop topso to switch fish brain. I have never done a switch fish brain in my life. In fact, I'm pretty sure I'd just be on the ground clutching my shin. When he's not finessing skate parks, he is grinding through hedges. Again, I'm pretty sure that Macchio is switch. Also, Sven Bokhurst, just, you know, acting like a young man out there in the Netherlands. Here he is doing a fakie 720 down a stair set like it's nothing. Do his knees just not age? Like, I'm 39 and my knees and ankles are in bits. When he's not floating over stair sets, he's doing triple rail transfers. And when he's not doing that, he's gapping off rails that are pretty much roof height. I have no idea what the hell is in John Julio and Sven Bokhurst's diet. I feel like they're on that Tony Hawk youth serum. Whatever they've got, whatever they're injecting into themselves, give me some. Also, if you haven't been paying attention recently, Demetrious George was just in Europe and he was on the killing spree once again. Killing himself. This guy, for someone who claims to like have a lot of respect for their body and eat healthy and treat themselves well, he treats his body like a teenager treats their first car. He just runs that shit into the ground. although the results he gets from destroying himself on a daily basis are very impressive. You kind of got to wonder what it is Demetrious George is planning. Like, he doesn't need the money, he's got a good job, he seems to have a successful career, and he doesn't really seem to be trying to get sponsored, because surely Powerslide would have picked him back up by now. If he's just doing this for the fun of it, that is a very painful way to have fun.
Oh god, I love it! Oh god, that hurt a little, but I'm alright.
I feel like he must have some kind of master plan.
Thinking of a master plan.
Because he's been working on this VOD for ages. In fact, it's starting to feel like the Richie Eisler VOD that's just never going to come out. And I just feel like he's got some grand, you know, plot that we are unaware of yet. Let us in on the secret, Demetrious. What you got going? And I'm going to close things out with Colin Kelso, one of my favorite skaters of all time, although he has had some questionable outfit choices over the years, namely the fedora and the leather glove. Anyway, here he is, absolutely rinsing a wizard setup, looking like a beautiful ballerina in the streets.